Hey everyone, it is October 13th, 2020, and check this article that just got published. Coming out of Yahoo News, Boeing and General Atomics join forces on a new laser weapon. Here we go. You see how they just slip it out little by little by little. This is how they do it, how they desensitize people to it. We already know they have all these laser weapons. We know what they're doing with directed energy, but the masses don't believe that. Well, so what they can do here is just, you know, just keep showing them this type of stuff. There was one where about a month ago they talked about the crowd denial system, okay, where they shoot microwaves at people that are protesting and rioting, and it stops them in their tracks. So they're going to continue to leak these stories so that people start getting desensitized and say, oh, okay, yeah, that's right, they've had that. Yeah, that's normal, that's normal, that's normal, you know? Says Washington, General Atomics and Boeing are teaming up to build a new high-energy laser for air and missile defense, the companies announced on October 13th. Under the agreement, the companies will create a 100-kilowatt laser that will be scalable to 250 kilowatts. The company stated in a news release, the weapon will be able to be employed as a standalone system or integrated onboard ground vehicles. There we go, onboard ground vehicles coming after us. When you're rioting, think the riots still aren't planned perfectly? Ships and aircraft, says General Atomics, electromagnetic system will be responsible for the laser batteries and thermal management system, while Boeing will create the beam director and software necessary for the precision tracking and pointing of the laser. Right, you know, you see here we're talking about, you know, General Atomics, and you got Boeing working together. This all goes back, you got Lockheed Martin, all of them working on this type of stuff. You know, and how convenient that Boeing, right, the ones that just get bailed out, billions of dollars given to them because of this, you know, whole, you know, fallout due to CV, you know, they bail out the airlines. Well, now what do they use all that money for? To create weapons against you. These are not just to be used in war or, you know, in other places. Of course, they're going to use it there, but it's definitely going to be used domestically. Although the companies did not specify whether the system is being built with a particular acquisition program in mind, the power levels that General Atomics and Boeing hope to achieve with their laser coincides with the Army is aiming for in its high-energy laser tactical vehicle demonstrator program. It's all planned. You better stop protesting. You better stop rioting. They're going to bring these in worldwide. This is not just a United States thing. It says the service has already tapped Dynetics and... Look at that. I didn't even read that all the way. I only read the headline and just had to make the video. Look at that. Lockheed Martin. Exactly. You know, we know it all was, it's all planned out. To build the initial HEL-TVD demonstrator, a 100-kilowatt class laser that would be integrated with a family of medium tactical vehicles platform. But the surface ultimately hopes to develop 250 to 300-kilowatt class directed energy weapons for future requirements. What are those requirements? Maybe causing wildfires, you know, building these hurricanes, you know, making them rapidly intensify. Yeah. It says the HEL-TVD demonstrator is a pathway to fielding a directed energy weapon as the part of the indirect fires protection capability in increment 2. It says the Army is in the process of putting laser fiber molecules that build up components that get a laser up to 300 kilowatts. Lieutenant General Neil Thurgood, the Army's Rapid Capabilities and Critical Technologies Office's director, told Defense News in a recent interview ahead of the Association of the U.S. Army's annual conference. It says the Army will demonstrate the capability in fiscal 2022. Think this all lines up perfectly for Agenda 21 and Agenda 2030? They're putting it on a truck, which means they just like their little Humvees driving around everywhere, they will have these on them. Says, part of a broader Pentagon program, the HEL-TVD is the Army's contribution, a competitive demonstration between the services. The Navy and the Air Force are also developing laser demonstrators at the same power level. At the end of FY22, the service and the Defense Department will decide which of those three are the best in breed, Thurgood said. The Army will then build four vehicle prototypes to be delivered in FY24. So you're talking 2020. Look at this. This all lines up. Once Agenda 21 takes over, this is all going to come out to get them to 2030 and to get them to, you know, their agenda to 2050, the megacities and sustainable development. Says GAM-EMS and Boeing provided scant details about the proposed weapon system, such as how long it will take to develop. However, they emphasize the laser's compact size and small logistics footprint. GA-EMS has made significant advancements in developing and demonstrating highly scalable laser technologies to facilitate high output power in smaller, lighter weight packages. Well, you know, right? Causing all of these wildfires? Yep, we know it. We look forward to working with Boeing in delivering a laser weapon system with capabilities designed that can meet current operational requirements, with providing the flexibility and adaptability to suit emerging platform requirements supporting missions across multi-domain battle space. It's all planned out, everyone. It says, Norm Tu, the Vice President and General Manager of Boeing Missile and Weapon System, added that the partnership will deliver an innovative high-energy laser force protection capability to the warfighter that is capable of supporting future needs and modernizing objectives. What do you think the future needs are? They're there to control you. We know where this is headed. So do they, because they planned it. The laser teaming partnership comes just weeks after the two companies announced a separate agreement to compete together for the Missile Defense Agency's Next Generation Interceptor program. Boeing and General Atomics will face off against Lockheed Martin and a Northrop Grumman Raytheon Technologies team in the competition to build a new ballistics missile interceptor. Here you go. Lockheed Martin, Raytheon, these are all ones we've talked about in the past. I've covered them. You know, Boeing, they all have these directed energy weapons, and they've been working on them over and over and over again. And they're not going to stop. So you're just going to see more and more of it. And then eventually you're most likely going to be staring down at it on your streets. So it's definitely time to prepare. It's time to share this information. People need to see it. People need to know that this is all set up. There is no doubt. They know what's coming. Okay? Everybody stay safe. Stay strong. Continue to pray. We truly, truly, truly need faith, and we all need each other right now. So prayers for everyone affected by all of this that's going on, and just prayers for everyone to continue to have the strength to fight through. Continue to share this information. Continue to try to save one more person that you can wake up with your information. That's why I do it, and I know that's why you keep putting up with it as too. Let's keep doing it. I'll talk to you all real soon. God bless.